Tehran dubbed it Operation Honest Promise. Waves of drones and missiles launched at Israel over 5 hours. How many of them reached their target, though? Honestly, hardly any. So, did Iran underestimate Israeli defenses, or was a large degree of failure factored in from the start? The attack started with 170 drones launched from Iran towards Israel. An hour later, the UAVs were joined by over 30 cruise missiles that can reach Israel in just over an hour. Finally, over 120 ballistic missiles, which take just between 10 and 15 minutes to arrive. At the same time, drone attacks were launched by the Houthis in Yemen and Iran-backed militias in Iraq, while Hezbollah fired missiles at Israeli positions in the Golan Heights. But Israel's missile defense systems, plus a combined air effort from Israel, the US, the UK, France and Jordan, meant none of the drones or cruise missiles even reached Israeli airspace, with the majority intercepted over Iraq and Syria. Like the remnants of this missile found in northern Iraq. Iran's Islamic Revolutionary Guard said the operation was more successful than expected, which begs the question, what were they expecting? On the streets of Tehran over the weekend, fireworks of an altogether less lethal variety, as some celebrated the fact that the attack was launched, although ultimately foiled. Its limited impact thanks to two things: nearly 40 years of investment in Israel's anti-missile defense systems underwritten by the US, and close cooperation between Israel and its allies in the air. Those missiles that made it past the Allied Air Force efforts faced a three-tier defense system. First up, the long-range Arrow system. It was designed specifically with Iranian missiles in mind. Each of these systems' rockets costs a few million dollars each. They can intercept missiles outside the Earth's atmosphere, resulting in these distinctive purple explosions seen on Saturday. The second layer of defense, the so-called David Sling system, is for taking out missiles and drones. And finally, the Iron Dome, which stops most short-range rocket attacks. Israel said that the systems combined meant that 99% of last Saturday's attack was intercepted. But some of Iran's ballistic missiles did get through. The ones that did show that one of the targets of the attack was the Nevatim Air Base in southern Israel. That's where Israel keeps its fleet of F-35 jets. Israel says the damage to the base was minimal and didn't affect the runway. Iran said it had warned countries about the attack 72 hours beforehand, although US officials said it hadn't got a heads up in advance. As Israel contemplates its response now, one of the questions to consider: was this Iran looking to demonstrate power, or to get more directly involved in this war?